What's up, my people? This is Showbiz the Adult. Alright, man, look. So, this is a quick video about Floyd Money Mayweather's record. His 16 consecutive fights against title holders. Whoops! Alright, man, look. Let's get to the video. First, I want to say this. I was sitting back listening to The Chronic. You know, Dr. Dre's The Chronic has been released finally on Tidal. You know what, Dre? I'm still waiting on that Detox album, man. I'm waiting on it. Alright, man, look. So, Floyd Money Mayweather, he released on, his Instagram. You know, I put it on my community. You know, Floyd Mayweather talking about a record that may never be broken. And that's, taking on 16 consecutive fights against title defense holders. And I know there's a lot of you who are commenting now, arguing, going back and forth. And here's the thing. My question was it a great record, okay? Or are there too many belts? Now, here's my answer to that. It's both, okay? And here's what I mean. I see a lot of people pretty harsh about Floyd Mayweather and the opponents and all those guys, all those title holders on the record, saying things like, you know, pretty much that he still ducked the challenges, fighting guys, picking and choosing, whatever it is. But I want to say this, okay? That's a great record. It is, all right? Floyd Mayweather taking on 16 title holders in a row, that is great. And here's how you know. You have people like people that we complain about, Jamal Charlo. You have people, I don't know, Triple G. You have, I don't know, Devin Haney. You have guys out there. Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder. You have, you know, you got guys out there that, you know, many boxing fans have complained about, saying that they're not taking on this guy, they're ducking this guy, ducking that guy. These guys aren't doing what Floyd Money Mayweather did. Floyd Money Mayweather took on guys with titles 16 times consecutively. That is a great accomplishment. We can't complain about one thing and then complain about the other at the same time. It's a great accomplishment. Just like Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao, you know, 8th division title holder. That's a great, excellent record, all right? But at the same time, there's too many belts. For both of those records, it is a reflection on how there's too many belts. You had guys like Berto and Maidana and the Ghost Guerrero. You had guys there. Sean Bay Mitchell, he was a good fighter. But you had all those guys are good fighters, but champions, though. You know, you look at them and you say, man, hold on. These guys were champions at the time? It's because they held a title. There are too many titles. Which is why Henry Armstrong, and what he did, you know, holding the featherweight title, lightweight title, welterweight title, hold all those titles consecutively, hold all those titles simultaneously, why that is such a huge accomplishment and better than Floyd Mayweather's 16 consecutive bouts with title holders, and better than even Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao holding his, gaining a title in 8 different weight classes. It's better than that because there were only, I think, 8 divisions in total. There were no tweener weight classes when Henry Armstrong was taking these guys on. And he was the champion simultaneously in 3 different weight classes. I know Canelo Alvarez is doing that now. But if you look at Canelo Alvarez, the belts that he's holding, and the weight classes, middleweight, super middleweight, like Henry Armstrong holding them in no, you know, super featherweight, light welterweight, junior welterweight, none of those things. He held titles simultaneously in featherweight, lightweight, and welterweight. So, yes, there are too many titles, okay? But it's that way right now. And people aren't doing what Floyd Money Mayweather did, taking on 16 title holders consecutively. It's a great accomplishment. And, you know, you have this type of thinking from boxing fans now, where no matter what, you're criticized, no matter what, okay, and you're criticized heavily, no matter what, we're burning the candle from both ends. And an example of that is when I brought up Tyson Fury, Tyson the Gypsy King Fury, and Iron Mike Tyson. And I brought up that Fantasy Fighters on my channel. You guys need to watch that video. I really, really went into a deep dive analysis. But I have comments because I said that Iron Mike Tyson on his resume, he had Evander the Real Deal, Holyfield, and Lennox Lewis. And they said, well, he lost. How is that part of his resume? That's the thinking that's making boxing terrible now. It's the fans that is sculpting, shaping these boxers to being duckers. If I get a loss, that's not a good thing for my resume. Positive thing about my resume isn't that I took on everybody. I have to beat everybody. So I must take on guys that I know I can beat. That's the thinking, and we're shaping that thinking. There was a time Joe Frazier fighting Muhammad Ali 3 times. That's great for his resume. He fought Ali 3 times. Yeah, he lost twice. He didn't just have Ali on his resume the fight that he won. He took on Ali 3 times. That's amazing. Gotti Ward, they fought 3 times, gave us great fights. That's amazing. So Marquez taking on Manny Pacquiao. He lost to Manny Pacquiao. He had a draw. He lost to him 2 times. And then he knocked out Manny Pacquiao. The two losses and the draw. Does it matter for Marquez? No, it matters. De La Hoya taking on all the guys that he fought. Bernard Hopkins, he lost to him, but he fought him. He fought Floyd Mayweather, he lost to him, but he fought him. That is great. De La Hoya, he took them all on. There should be some sort of applause for that by the boxing fans. And if we were to reward those guys for taking them all on, there wouldn't be duckers today. So I think us as boxing fans, we have to check ourselves. What Floyd Money Mayweather did in taking on those fights, that record is amazing. It is. Showbiz the adult. Instead of hating all the time, let's find something to be appreciative about. That way, boxers may just give us the fights we want. I'm out.